Hi, this is Jason Lewis, Midday's Technophile. Today we'll be looking at the new game, Immortals Phoenix Rising. To create Immortals Phoenix Rising, Ubisoft has taken Greek mythology, slapped on its Assassin's control scheme, and dumbed down the graphics. That said, it is not a bad game for most part. The story starts when the demon Typhoon gets released from his underground prison, causing chaos in the world by defeating the gods. You play a nobody named Phoenix, and it is your destiny to save the world, as Prometheus narrates your life story to Zeus. While the overarching story is pretty good, I did not enjoy the feeble attempts at humor.
No! Look at me! You are not ready.
The supposedly funny dialogues and comic chemistry between Zeus and Prometheus are akin to nails on a blackboard.
Oh no, not another of your boring stories. How long is this going to take?
However, this is probably the only major grouse I have with Immortals. One of the great things about the game is that it uses the control scheme of Assassin's Creed. And anyone familiar with that will be pleasantly surprised how easy it is to navigate this world. Though there are some hangover elements of Assassin's Creed Odyssey in this game, it has carved itself out to be a much lighter, less serious experience. This is partly thanks to the graphics, where everything looks like it's a cartoon version of its mythological self. The way the combat is handled also makes this a very easy and stress-free experience. Phoenix Rising has an open world, which means you can explore and reveal the full map at any time you like. There are also puzzles of various levels of difficulty peppered through the entire map. While some are easy, others can be pretty tough. The puzzles, even when you figure them out, have a fair bit of grunt work, which can get tedious at times. The game map is pretty huge, but you can fast travel to select locations and then glide from there to the next point of interest. This makes things easy if you're trying to complete the main quest. However, doing so will deprive you of the hidden treasures, combat opportunities, and puzzles. It's best to find a horse and travel that way, especially if you want to catch all the sights. You're looking at an easy 40 to 60 hours of gameplay. You can also replay the entire game in the plus mode once you have finished the main quest. Immortals is an amazing game that is let down by its atrocious attempts at comedy. Every bit of this game otherwise is fun. I like the light-hearted approach. I felt the object here was to unwind and explore, rather than chase down one quest after the other. Even the graphics, though simplistic, worked for this game. If you're looking for an enjoyable RPG with lots of puzzles and things to do, then go for this. It is simple to learn and play, especially if you have played Assassin's Creed before.
Subscribe to Midday India. Get direct notifications on all our videos by clicking on the bell icon.